Hi everyone, welcome to the YouTube channel Skills to Scale. Listen Mahabharat in simple English by Shruti Bhushan. In the previous video, we have seen the fall of one legend, Bhishma. Today we will see further. If you haven't watched the previous video, please watch it. And also like, share and subscribe to Skills to Scale to get more videos. Drona takes charge as the commander of the Kaurava army after Bhishma's fall. With Bhishma out of the war scene, the son of Sun, that is Karna, also made his entry into Kurukshetra. As the 11th day started, Duryodhana told Drona to capture Yudhishthira and end the war. Drona was happy that Duryodhana probably made some sense. With capturing Yudhishthira, Drona thought a big bloodshed can be revived. Then Duryodhana told his sinister plan of tricking the Pandavas for another game of dice and sending them to exile again. Drona told Duryodhana that his evil thoughts would never change. But Drona still agreed to capture Yudhishthira for the larger sake of preventing the death of all his loved ones. Drona and Yudhishthira choose the Shakata cart formation and Karuncha Vyuha respectively. Karuncha Vyuha was the most common formation in the war. Drona almost had Yudhishthira captured as promised to Duryodhana. But an arrow came out of nowhere to save Yudhishthira. The arrow came from the Gandiva. Drona now turned his attention to Arjuna. They both fought for a long time. The day also ended. On the 12th day, meanwhile, Satyajit, one of the Maharathis, was left in charge of protecting Yudhishthira. Drona charged towards Yudhishthira, but was stopped by Dhrishtadyumna and Satyajit. The fierce two versus one battle ended with the death of Satyajit. Shikhandini, Satyaki and Virata's son came to Dhrishtadyumna's help. Virata's son got killed and the other two tried hard to engage Drona, keeping him away from Yudhishthira. Drona, however quickly, was backed up by Karna and Duryodhana. Soon, Bhima came charging like a mad elephant. Duryodhana resent his elephant army to tackle Bhima. Bhima finished the army in minutes. Bhagadatta then came face to face with Bhima on his mighty elephant, Supradipam. A fierce battle took place between Bhima and the elephant, which was as famous as Airavat, Lord Indra's mount. Arjuna, hearing the booming elephant and his roaring brother, tried to come to his brother's aid, and with a shower of arrows attacked Supradipam. One snake-like arrow finally killed Supradipam, which enraged Bhagadatta. Bhagadatta summoned the Narayana Astra, one of the most powerful astras in Hindu mythology, which was under his possession. The sky became clear and after a flash of lightning appeared the Narayana Astra as bright as Lord Narayana himself. Bhagadatta hurled the Astra at Arjuna. Arjuna thought that he definitely could not fight the Narayana Astra and closed his eyes to accept his end. One should not forget, Arjuna's charioteer was Krishna, the ultimate strategist. Krishna rose up from the chariot and absorbed the very astra. The powerful astra charged only to fall as a garland around Krishna's neck. Arjuna opened his eyes. He realized what had happened and asked Krishna the intent behind his action. Krishna smiled and said, "I just retrieved what was mine." Coming to Bhagadatta, he actually was a very old man, so old that his eyebrows fell over his eyes. To prevent his vision being completely blocked, he always tied the eyebrows with a cloth around his temple. Arjuna thought wisely and with a well-aimed arrow, he cut off his cloth blocking Bhagadatta's vision. Arjuna then used this opportunity and pierced Bhagadatta's heart. Let's see the remaining part in my next video. If you liked the story and felt it interesting, drop a like. Share it with your friends and let them know about Mahabharata. Also, don't forget to subscribe for more